Hello everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel WP Fresher WordPress Tutorials. Today I'm gonna show you how you can solve errors while starting Apache and MySQL in the XAMPP Control Panel. For Apache, the maximum number of people are facing issues with the XAMPP default port 80 in used by other software. And for the MySQL, MySQL Shutdown Unexpectedly, this may be due to a block port or something else. Let's see the errors. Here is my XAMPP Control Panel, and let's click on the Start button to start the Apache server. It's not working because a problem was detected. Port 80 in use by unable to open process with PID 4. Apache will not start without the configured ports free. You need to uninstall, disable, or reconfigure the blocking application, or reconfigure Apache and the control panel to listen on a different port. Again, let's click on the Start button to start the MySQL server. It's also not working. It's because an error was detected. MySQL Shutdown Unexpectedly. This may be due to a block port, missing dependencies, improper privileges, a crash, or a shutdown by another method. Now, let's see how you can solve those issues. First of all, click on the config button, then click on Apache httpd.conf, then press Ctrl F on the keyboard and search 80 and change it to 8080 everywhere. Then save the file and close the file. Again, click on the config button, then click on Apache httpd-ssl.conf, then press Ctrl F on the keyboard and search for 333 and change it to 4433 everywhere. Again, save the file and then close it. Well, now let's start the Apache server again. It's started successfully. Remember, to get the server access, you need to browse localhost clone your custom port 8080/psbmyadmin or your custom directory instead of localhost/psbmyadmin. It's displaying error because MySQL server is not running. For MySQL, you need to follow a few steps to solve the issue. Hope you also can do it easily without losing database files if you follow this video carefully. Remember, do not skip while doing this. Open the XAMPP folder where you installed it. Then, open the MySQL folder. First of all, take a backup of both backup and data folder. Separately, I'm going to make those files as a zip. Well, backup completed. Now, rename the data folder to data-old and then rename the backup folder to data. Now, open the data-old folder and copy all the folders from data-old except MySQL Performance Schema PSP MyAdmin and also copy IB data on from the data old folder. Go back to data folder and paste it inside the data folder. Click on replace the file in the destination. Back to the MySQL directory and you can extract the backup.zip file to get back to your old backup folder. All done. You can now try starting Apache and MySQL server from XAMPP Control Panel. Wow, it's running. And also the PSP MyAdmin working. If all things are working well, then you can delete the data old folder. Hope you already started loving us. A small request to you, please subscribe to our YouTube channel, WP Fresher WordPress Tutorials. We published awesome videos every week to make the WordPress website better. Thank you.